Welcome to the Voice of Vietnam on the Wind. On today's show, astronaut news. Current interviews will start really confident news and hopes of covering official visit to Cuba and his participation in the UN General Assembly. I would like to announce that news will report on how blood clotting earlier has radically changed for more foundational people's lives. Finally, the culture edition will introduce the YouTube channel, real-life storytelling of the Voice of Vietnam, which has won the Silver Trident Award. But first, here's the news. In headlines, Vietnam's fifth FDA approval prevents the wind-blown COVID-19 vaccine and its products. Samsung, when it spawned portable devices production capacity in Vietnam, in turn applies to join the Pacific Trade Pact, CPTPP, and has the news in detail. President Sinpo's upcoming official visit to Cuba starting from Saturday is the great significance that Vietnamese ambassador to Cuba, Lee Thanh Tung, Mr. Tung, told the Voice of Vietnam. The visit affirms Vietnam's determination to promote the fraternal solidarity and enhance the cooperation in mutual trust between the two parties, states and peoples. During the visit, the leaders of both countries are expected to discuss measures to foster the comprehensive cooperation between Vietnam and Cuba, especially in economy, trade, and investments. Ambassador Tung said Vietnam-Cuba relations are special. Vietnam allies stand by Cuba and share its own financial development and assist Cuba in its effort to ensure food security. Vietnam is Cuba's second largest trade partner and biggest investor in the Asia-Pacific region. In the fight against COVID-19, Vietnam and Cuba have supported each other, he said. Deputy Prime Minister REUPLOAD has asked for completion of the dossier of the wind-blown products that sent to submit for urgent consent, according to a notice released by the government office. Mr. Dan also urged assistance for rival firms in testing the antivirus drug molnupiravir. In the notice sent to the Ministry of Health is required to give more support to COVID-19 vaccines research units in completing and supplementing dossiers for vaccines. First of all, the normal products to submit to relevant agencies for consideration and emergency approval. Deputy Prime Minister then asked the Ministry to collect recommendations of experts on the use of COVID-19 vaccines for children, the combination of vaccines and plans for vaccines use in 2020. The Minister is also asked to guarantee vaccinated firms in the trial of the antiviral drug molnupiravir and design plans to ensure the availability of treatment drugs to meet the demand in the situation of rapid increases in COVID-19 patients, while speeding up the clinical trial and evaluation of the efficacy of the vaccinated drug for COVID-19 treatment researched and produced by the Vietnam Academy of Science and Technology. The Deputy Permanent Representative of Vietnam to the UN has raised his concern about the negative consequences of the illegal trade in smart guns and light weapons that makes conflicts prolonged and causes negative impacts on peace efforts and socio-economic development. Addressing a virtual UN Security Council meeting on Thursday, Ambassador Fadre emphasized Vietnam's support for regional and international cooperation efforts to complement national efforts, especially in coordination of activities and resources and expertise and experience sharing. He stressed the need to both ensure the fight against illegal weapon trade and avoid negative impacts on the national capacity to safeguard national defense and security, even in the transitional and post-conflict times and in many places at present. Samsung Electronics will begin expanding the production of the foldable devices that is planned in Vietnam's northern province of Dasmariñas within the second half of this year, according to the Korean Economics Daily.
Samsung display will increase its annual production capacity of 40 volts by 47% from the current 17 million to 24 million. The project target for full operation by the end of this year or early next year at the latest. I specify that once Samsung completes the expansion, the company will be able to produce 10 million units of Z40 models and 15 million units of Z50 models per year. Samsung's decision to ramp up capacity is mainly driven by soaring market demand. Its first generation foldable models recorded more than 20,000 pre-orders in the Republic of Korea, 1.8 times more than its latest smartphone Galaxy S21. Numerous pre-orders for the new foldable phones was even higher in China in more than 1 million. In Vietnam, Samsung is running 6 in building research and development center. Investing nearly $18 million in the country so far, the company is employing 102,000 employees. The National Innovation Startup Festival, Texas, Vietnam 2021 was launched on Thursday aimed at enhancing the role of solutions from innovative startups in responding to the pandemic as well as contributing to economic recovery. Deputy Minister of Finance and General Xu Chengbanping said, as the COVID-19 pandemic has made the startup efforts much more challenging this year, it is essential to change the way of working and communication soon.
Businesses, especially startup businesses. We expect to receive more startup business initiatives to help contain and react safely to COVID-19. TechFest 2021 includes more than 50 conferences and seminars, investment connections, among other activities, from September to December.
And now some world news. China has found an application to join the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership, or CPTPP, as the world's second biggest economy who looks to bolster its clout in trade. Commerce Minister Wang Guangtang submitted China's application to join the free trade deal in a letter to New Zealand's Trade Minister Damien O'Connor, the Chinese ministry said in a statement made on Thursday. The CPTPP was signed by 11 countries including Australia, Canada, Chile, Japan, and New Zealand in 2018. Before that, it was known as the Trans-Pacific Partnership and was central to former U.S. President Barack Obama's strategic pivot to Asia. But his successor, Donald Trump, withdrew the U.S. from the pact in 2017. Japan, the CPTPP's chair this year, said it will consult with many countries to respond to China's request, but stopped short of signaling a timeline for doing so. Britain in June began negotiations to enter the trade pact, while Taiwan has also signed interest in joining it. The European Union set out a formal strategy of the state to boost its presence in the Indo-Pacific, pledging to deploy new ships to set open sea routes. Following an initial plan in April, the EU set out with 7 areas in which it would increase influence in the Indo-Pacific in trade, security, data, infrastructure, the environment, trade, and oceans. The plan will need a higher EU diplomatic profile on Indo-Pacific issues, mining personnel, and investment innovation, and a security program such as dispatching ships through the South China Sea, called the Deep Sea in Vietnam, or putting Europeans on Australian patrols. Quote, given the importance of a meaningful European naval presence in the Indo-Pacific, the EU will explore ways to ensure enhanced naval deployment by its member states in the region, unquote, the document said.
Family Time News, hear that voice once again. Because of the approval process for long-grown COVID-19 vaccines now in COVID, Samsung will expand foldable devices production capacity in Vietnam. And China applies to join the Pacific Trade Pact, CPTPP.
and their stores. Foreign relations.
Based on that, Mr. Fuchs first visit to Cuba is also the first time the attempts at a rival general debate of the UN General Assembly as president. The visit at the invitation of first secretary of the French Committee of the Communist Party of Cuba and Cuban President Miguel Díaz-Canel anticipates the 61st anniversary of Balazs of Ibn Maitre's on December the 2nd this year. Despite domestic and global challenges in the past six decades, the expansion of international friendship between Vietnam and Cuba has been unceasingly cultivated, consolidated, and developed. Deputy Prime Minister Phan Minh Minh described the special friendship, solidarity, and mutual trust between Vietnam and Cuba as rain in international relations. The two countries have built close friendship and extensive cooperation, merging the two parties, governments, national assemblies, and making political social organizations. During the August 23rd Hong Kong, President Winston Frederick and President Miguel Díaz-Canel once again affirmed the unshakable solidarity between Vietnam and Cuba, who are ready to support each other in any circumstances. Deputy Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Zhang said.
In the current context, the Southwest hope for one another is even more meaningful. As Vietnam is struggling with the fourth wave of COVID-19, Cuba has provided us with vaccines. Vietnam also sent food aid to Cuban people who are undergoing a difficult time. The spirit of a friend in need is a friend indeed has been clearly reflected in the Vietnam-Cuba traditional fraternity.
After the Cuba visit, President Phuc will attend the high-level general debate of the UN General Assembly just in the right time on the 74th anniversary of Vietnam's accession to the UN on September 20th. Over the past 44 years, Vietnam has joined the world body in resolving regional and global peace and security issues and promoting human rights. UN Western Coordinator Tamana Rocha said Vietnam has an increasingly important role at the UN as a result of its active and responsible contribution to the international community and the UN. In a phone conversation with President Trump on June 19th, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres specifically acknowledged Vietnam's active and responsible contributions to the UN and international affairs, calling Vietnam an important factor contributing to peace and stability in the region. There were two ministers that made his own sense.
The President's participation in the high-level discussion session of the United Nations General Assembly is an opportunity for Vietnam to convey the message of an independent, self-reliant, aspirational, and visionary Vietnam, which has adopted a foreign policy of openness, multilateralization, and diversification of international relations. Vietnam will continue to contribute responsibly to the international community for peace and development. At next is our wildlife settlements. Locally, a remote commune in Gangwon District, Gangwon Gardens, has fed away out of poverty. The couple farming has radically changed Dongkai and Gangwon coastline.
raising cuckoos in industrial farms began in 2010 when some disadvantaged locals started raking feedback cuckoos for an extra income. After the trial in which the black cuckoos grew first, while being raised with shrimp, the donkey farmers decided to expand the model, which has already made the farmers in England-handed rich. Spacious houses have mushroomed. Leventhal, a venture who has raised black cuckoos for just 2 years, already has enough money to build a new house. He told VOV that in the past, he and his neighbors made a living raising shrimp and crabs in ponds, but his family didn't have much land and remained poor. When the model of black cuckoo farming began to flourish in the commune, Todd decided to devote his family 0.7 acre land to raising this species of shrimp. He made nearly $8,900 from his 2017 harvest. A couple of years later, his family replaced their crude wooden shack with a more spacious world house.
They all carry shrimp and crabs, which are all quantities, but they mainly rely on black cockles. Black cockles give high yields and strong profits, improving our living tradition, and it's easier than raising crabs.
The black cockle farming model came around just as the entire community was beginning a new style world building program. The black cockle has been selected as one of the community's spearhead economic products. With a profit of about $4,400 per hectare per year, many households will in turn escape poverty and become well off. The foreign per capita income is more than $2,200 a year, twice as much as when the new style world building began 11 years ago. A 5.5-kilometer paved road was completed in 2001 last year, thanks to villagers and organizations. When the local government announced plans to create a village pit and improve urban areas, the villagers responded immediately, as they no longer have to struggle to earn their daily bread and butter. This was why simultaneously complying with social distancing regulations, such as the government.
Many of the teams are working in the fields to identify the areas around our houses. Because we were told our community is recognized as a new style rural village this November. If we don't do it, how can we be recognized? Homeless officials have encouraged us to do the upgrading, but we must strictly follow the Ministry of Health epidemic regulations wherever we go outside.
When the new style rural development program began in 2010, Dr. Hamlet met only three criteria. We only need three more criteria to reach the finish line. Modern Chief Chairman of the Community Speakers Committee said,
of course, we face some difficulties caused by the pandemic, but we're determined to reach our goals by dividing into small groups and recognizing every household to complete its task. Social distancing has an advantage in some ways. Since everyone has to stay at home, it's easier to see what has been completed and focus on unfinished tasks.
Expanding production and improving people's income and living standard are important criteria for new style rural areas. Long-term success in fulfilling these criteria has helped the once disadvantaged community mobilize people to contribute to the new style rural building process.
Here we go with the clinical statement. After 1 year since its debut, the YouTube channel, VOV Live Storytelling of the North of Vietnam, has attracted more than 100,000 followers in after that YouTube follow button. The channel now has around 24 million viewers, connecting many literature lovers in Vietnam and the world. Their time stories, long episodes, have long been signature programs of the Voice of Vietnam. Besides classic literature works, VOV also updates many new works by young writers. Journalist Chen Nhật Minh, head of the VOV's Department of Literature and Arts, who is in charge of storytelling shows, said,
The storytelling show is now live streamed at 10 p.m. every day. Each blast from 10 to 15 minutes. The victim learns family issues and other aspects of life, accompanied by self-background music.
Highlighting the determination and united efforts to stem out the coronavirus pandemic has closed our show for today. Thank you very much for spending time with us on Voice of Vietnam. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.